Alright, so we're on the play for game two, and we'll see how it goes. And that seems like a decent enough draw for game two. We're going to be able to get a turn four scoop mob active, which I cannot complain about. And we do have a tectonic edge. Hopefully we'll draw into some other good removal spells. But we're going to get the scoop mob into play right away. I don't know when we're going to have green available besides only Haro. I guess we can see if he mulligans, but I don't mind this draw. He's going to have a journey to combat the scoop mob early. I'm going to lead with forest and explore into the red. Right now I feel like sacrificing. We do have a lot of lands in our deck. Okay, so right now the plan is to play the edge, and or we'll still keep the we'll play the Misty, and we're not gonna play any other spells, and we're just going to attack and say go, and Haro during his turn. He might have cancel mana up, so. I guess, yeah, I'm not going to risk it. We'll make him be proactive. Still not going to play that Explore, because if he has Jace, then I can Haro and Common Storm it out, and then be able to replay the Scoop Mob next turn. And blow up one of his lands. Oh, he's just gonna Day of Judgment. I'm gonna sacrifice the Misty so I don't have to take away all my lands in the deck. And we're gonna go to my turn before we decide to Tectonic Edge. We'll explore. And I feel like taking care of a land. He might be protecting his green, but still see that being worth it. Oh, and then he goes and destroys mine. It's a little late. Wonder where all his green mana went. So now it's just a dance, and see who comes out ahead. I'm kind of scared of next turn if he has Sphinx, but we do have him dead. If I draw a mountain, or if I draw an untapped land. Interesting. So I'm almost sure he's got a cancel, and I kind of want him to use it. So we're going to take out the Gladeheart and him. And see if he counters it. And that he does. Alright. I don't see a point in holding on to this. And take out his man land. The reason I took that out is I don't want him to be able to kick a Sphinx. Alright, and I hope he doesn't have a counterspell for this one as well. And he is out of counterspells. So next turn we're going to be able to put a hole in his Sphinx and him. We might play around Spell Pierce next turn. Ooh. I don't think he'll have Spell Pierce. I'm not going to play around it. It would suck if he does. But I do not think he has room for that card. Alright, we're just a mountain away from victory. Oof. That was good. He has his forest to play his Baloth. And he decides not to do that. Discards one of his Baloths. Played the colonnade, and that's the game. Alright, so we get to game 3.